Hi there, it's Sam from PootlesPapercraft.uk. Thank you very much for joining me today. Today I do have a project for you, but I want to give you a little bit of background before I start building it. This is a bespoke box for my friend Nicoletta of Marshmallow Blends, and she is an artisan soap maker and wax melt maker, and she is raising money for the breast cancer campaign charity at the moment, and it's something that she holds very dear to her heart, and she often does something for them, and it's something that is close to my heart and, you know, within my family. So she has made some wax melts for the breast cancer charity that are in the shape of nipples. They are so fun, and she wanted to box them up, so my gift to her is that I promised her I would make 50 boxes for 50 pairs that she's going to be sending out. So I will put all of the details where you can get hold of them, marshmallowblends.co.uk, and they're going to be £3 a pair plus postage in the UK. But like I say, it's something that is very close to her heart, and that I was very proud to get involved in with her. So my donation to her is 50 boxes that I'm going to make in advance for her so that she can use them. So I'm going to show you how to make them, but also how to mass produce. I'm actually only going to make 4, but I know that some people struggle with mass production of boxes and cards and bags. So I'm going to show you how to make 4, because each one of these uses only a piece of card that is 6x6, which is 15.2x15.2. So you get 4 from a sheet of 12x12. So let me move that out of the way and bring in my sheet of 12x12 blushing bride cardstock, because obviously it's pink, you could just see them peeping through. So it's pink, so I'm going to do the stamping on here first, because as you can see, I've left it very plain deliberately, because Nicoletta's going to put her, you know, obviously she has to put ingredients listings and safety details, so she's going to put them on the bottom, but she might want to put her own tag on it as well, because it's a charity one. So that's why it's quite plain, but you need to do the stamping, so I shall stop chatting and start stamping. So I've got everything, Eleanor, because I just wanted a very gentle pattern on it. I didn't want it to be all about the box. So I've got everything, Eleanor, because I love this swooshy swirl. And I've got Blushing Bride because I wanted tone on tone. So this is a full sheet. And like I say, I'm only going to do 4, but I'm going to need to do quite a lot of sheets of these for Nick. And I'm going to pop in the post. She gets to stick them. So all you do, let me move that off there because I don't want to stamp all over that, is you just randomly stamp and do your whole sheet. Don't cut it down, don't cut them into the 6x6s. Start with your full sheet. And if you're going to mass produce, and like I say, I'm going to be doing a whole load more for her, so I'm going to sit and stamp all of the sheets that I need. How many sheets am I going to need? 12, 13 sheets, I think. Or 12 more, basically. So you sit and you stamp all of them in one go. So do all of your stamping first. So that's all my stamping. That's done. Put my stamp pad away so we can assume. Let's pretend that I've done another 12 sheets. So I've got my 12x12. Grab your trimmer and cut it down. So if I was going to cut it in inches, I'm just going straight on the 6, which is 15.2 centimetres. Cut one and cut the other. And then cut, so if you're mass producing lots, do all of it. So you've done all your stamping, now you do all your cutting. And it's quite rhythmic. Get some decent music going, you know, or any kind of music, whether it's decent or not. Something, maybe have the telly on, anything. And that's, you know, you just rhythmically do it. So you've got your big old pile and you've got it stacked to one side. When you've finished everything, then you come on to the next stage. And this is an envelope punch board project. So you grab your envelope punch board. I will give you the measurements, which I've got over here on my notes, but I forgot to fold the page over. Here we go. I didn't write it down properly. I'm going to have to wing this one. So You get your envelope punch board all ready, and you line it up to 1 5/8 of an inch, because that's specific to this. It's like one of my bag in my open baskets, but it's not. It's shorter and wider. So 1 5/8 of an inch, which is 4.2 centimetres. Punch and score. Slide to 3, which is 7.6 centimetres. And you keep going round. And that's what's going to give us the shape of this box. And this is one of those projects, because it's cardstock, you do need to put a little bit of extra force in. So when you're doing these, you are perhaps going to get a little touch of arm ache when you're done. Don't round the corners yet. Yeah, so get a chap involved. Get a man to help you when you're doing an envelope punch board project. Or a child. Children are always useful for mass production, particularly punching. They never seem to get enough of it. I get thumb ache after a while, but my boys could keep punching for hours. They could just keep going. So that's two done. And I am working on a series to come soon, which is going to be all about projects and products you can put into a craft fair. Because I get a lot of people saying to me that, you know, they've maybe used some of my projects at a craft fair and they've been really brilliant, great sellers, particularly, you know, projects where they've got candles in or sweeties or something like that. So I have promised that I will work on a series for craft fair projects. So if there's anything that you'd like to see, let me know. Do leave a comment. I do struggle to reply to comments on YouTube because it's quite a slow process to keep going and finding them all. So I do try and get around to them as much as I can. But if you want something urgent, email me, sam@pootlespapercraft.co.uk. And like I say, if you want to see something, there you go. So that's my four done. I'm going to move those out of the way. Come in around all your corners. So you would do all, you know, in my case, all 50 or 46, which is what I've got left over to do, all 50 of them, and then come and sit along and do all 50 of these. This is something to do of an evening when there's some telly on. You just sit there quite happily punching, and before you know it, they're all done. And I will sit and make all of the rest one evening for Nick before I pop them in the post to her. There we go. So that's those done. Envelope punch board out of the way. And now to start scoring. So again, you've got your stack of 50 and then you come along and score them all. And again, it is just a rhythm. It's a rhythm you get into with it. And that's what makes it so quick to do. I made 48 cards the other day in 6 different colourways. And it took about 4 hours because there was a lot of stuff going on each card, but it did only take 4 hours to make 48 cards. Now, I don't sell my cards, I give them away, but if I was taking them to a craft fair, that's not bad. That's not a bad hourly rate. 48 cards at £2 each, that's £96. So yeah, that would be £20 an hour, maybe a little bit more, or maybe a little bit less if you take off tax and what have you. So when you get into a rhythm, it makes the process faster. But I'm enjoying these. I was really pleased when Nick came to me to ask me to design the boxes for her. And immediately, obviously, I said, well, you know, it'll be my gift to help raise money. And she makes some really beautiful stuff. She's got this amazing stuff called shower fluff. And it's like a whipped mousse that is in a jar. And you scoop a bit out and rub it on your arms. You scoop it out dry. You can put a little bit of water in it. Put it on your arms. And then when you run the water over yourself in the shower, it all foams up. It's amazing stuff. And she does sugar scrub cubes that are like little, you know, cubes of sugar. And you break a tiny little bit off, rub it in your hand with a little bit of water, and it foams up, but it's exfoliating. And they're the most divine smells. They're amazing. Right, so we've now got our 50 of these. We'll pretend there's 50. And you want to have it so you've got your large triangle facing you and your little ones to the left and right, and cut either side of the large triangle on all sides. And again, with your production line, you're going to sit and do all of the cutting. coat all of these. This is not one to get the children involved in. They'd be cutting their fingers all sorts. So don't have them doing this part. Okay, so they're all done. Now the punching of the holes, which is at the top here. Now, when I've done holes in the top of these baskets before, I kept them closer up, but actually I wanted it to close that little bit more with these. So I've got my small oval punch, and you just push it in as far as it'll go. If I'm quiet for a second, that tap is where it's reaching the back of this part, and I can see that it's equidistant. So that's my hole punched. So that's one done. Two. And this is where you fire your punch out parts all over the room. Or you've, how can I punch that in the air and have it land on my thumb? I can never do that again. And they go everywhere, which is good fun. And your Hoover likes them. It's like the backing of dimensionals, they go everywhere. Those things breed, don't they? I don't do any crafting upstairs, but there's an awful lot up there. Right, final stage now, gluing. We need glue in these corners. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to lay all four out. I know you can't quite see all of all four. We'll pretend that you can. And I'm going to get my sticky strip. Actually, I'm not. I'm going to use liquid glue because these are boxes. And you come along and put a splodge in each of the corners. So I would say when you're working with liquid glue, no more than four projects at a time, because you don't want it to go too dry before you've actually stuck together. Let's move that out of the way slightly. So I'm going to come back to number one and fold and close in all of the sides. And actually, I'm going to be sending them to Nick while they're flat. I'm not going to have glued them first because I don't want them to risk squishing in the post. But I will be giving her instructions of where to put the glue. Or I might be brave and put, no, I won't put 50 pieces of sticky strip. Actually, that would be a 200 pieces of sticky strip for her. No, I'll just send her the sticky strip and she can do that bit herself. Because we know it hates me. So there's one. Bring that into shot. That's the second one. Just holding that for a second. Look, it's going to keep pinging open. I think my Tombow's decided it's camera shy today. Why does adhesive hate me? Or hate my camera? It's quite nice, my camera. There we go, so that's number two. Oh, it's number two that's twanged open. Number three. This is why you don't do more than four at a time, so you can keep sticking your hands in and out of the other ones. Yep, they've all closed up nicely now. Stop opening! Silly things. There we go. And then the last one. Bring that round. And then these ones round. And that one as well. How are we doing? 14 minutes. Oh, that's not bad. Could it be more? Because I never practice filming before I film, I never know how long a video is going to be. I'm always as surprised as you guys are, I think. So, there we go. And then we're going to bring in the ribbon, which I've put somewhere. I've got the Blushing Bride stitched ribbon. Again, I'm not going to be doing this for Nick. I will send her the ribbon and she can tie it herself. you know, when she's put the melts in. And wax melt, for anybody who doesn't know, is you have usually a ceramic burner that you put a tea light underneath, and then you put your wax melt in the top, and it melts and fragrances your home, your room, anything. And as I'm tying these, I will grab hers and have a sniff of these. That's quite a fruity scent, but there's a bit of a zingy after, sort of I wouldn't say aftertaste, because obviously I'm not eating them. There's a little fragrance that's coming, but definitely quite fruity and sweet, and very nice. Lemony, sherbety. She will have put a description on her website, so you'll be able to get the information there. Let's keep tying all the ribbons. And so obviously, so I forgot to say, yes, she would have stuck all 50 and then filled all 50 and then come along and be ribboned all 50, and then it would be job done. I do enjoy making lots of projects all in one go. When I make my thank you cards for all of the people who come shopping with me, I will generally make only about 8 of one kind. It's not very often that I will make, I mean, I'll make maybe 30 or 40, but they will be in different colourways. I like people to have something that thousands of people haven't got. So generally, once I've made a card that I've, you know, that I've sent out as a thank you card, I won't repeat it. Apart from anything, it's so that, you know, when people shop with me, no matter how many times they shop, I will always send a little gift and a thank you card, so they don't get the same card twice. But I like that little bit of exclusivity for them, that, you know, it's kind of like limited edition, I suppose, but that would be tooting my own trumpet, and that's not the intention. But I do enjoy making lots of projects in one go, and that is how you make four boxes very quickly. But 50 wouldn't take you 50 times 17 minutes. That's taken me 17 minutes to do four of them. So it would take you considerably less, because you would be doing all of it. But anyway, please go and look at Nick's shop. At the moment, she is only planning to send in the UK, but she might open it up. If her first 50 pairs go very quickly, she might consider opening it up to worldwide. But I think she does other shipping worldwide as well. Marshmallowblends.co.uk. Thank you very much for watching. Bye.